Today, Prime Minister Modi of India undertook his first foreign visit in 15 months. His destination was a country very special to India, the country of Bangladesh. The occasion too was very special. Today, Bangladesh is celebrating 50 years of its independence. It is also celebrating 50 years of its relationship with India and the birth centenary of its founding father, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. Bangladesh is a young country. It suffered countless atrocities at the hands of Pakistan. India launched a military offensive to end months of bloodshed, oppression and barbarity by the Pakistani army. Pakistan left Bangladesh weak. It had drained the resources and wealth of Bangladesh. Today, 50 years later, we are witnessing a dramatic turnaround. Bangladesh is an economic powerhouse. It engages with South Asia and the world from a position of strength. It has much to celebrate. So Dhaka invited India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi to be the chief guest for the occasion, and the Indian Prime Minister did not disappoint Dhaka. Earlier today, he kicked off a two-day visit to Bangladesh. And the fact that this is his first international tour in this pandemic should tell you the importance Delhi attaches to its ties with Dhaka. Upon arrival, Prime Minister Modi was given a red carpet welcome. He was received by Sheikh Hasina herself. The Bangladeshi Prime Minister was at the airport. Before Prime Minister Modi's arrival, an advisor to Sheikh Hasina had said that India is the quote-unquote most important neighbour of Bangladesh. And that showed in the reception that Mr. Modi got today. A salute of 19 guns and a guard of honour was accorded to him at the airport. His first stop was the National Martyrs Memorial in Savar. It's a monument built to honour those who died in the Bangladesh War of Independence. Prime Minister Modi paid his respects to the martyrs. He then held a range of engagements. He met with a delegation of opposition leaders, followed by a group of young achievers and various community leaders, including freedom fighters who participated in the liberation war. They're called the Mukti Jodhas in Bangladesh. In the evening, Prime Minister Modi attended the National Day ceremony. This year, India has awarded the Gandhi Peace Prize to Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, the founding father of Bangladesh, also Sheikh Hasina's father. It's a posthumous honour, and since Dhaka is celebrating his 100th birth anniversary, the award from India was a very special one for Sheikh Hasina and her sister. Prime Minister Modi came wearing a Mujib jacket gifted to him by Dhaka. In his speech, he shared an interesting story. He said that one of the first protests of his political career was for the freedom of Bangladesh. Prime Minister Modi said that he and his colleagues in the Jan Sangh back in the day had done a satyagraha for Bangladesh. They had protested outside parliament to push the Indian government to support Bangladesh. And he even went to jail for this. What you see on your screen now is a citation from the Bangladesh government honouring former Indian Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. It also talks about the Jan Sangh protest to support Bangladesh. Prime Minister Modi today said that he was in his 20s then and part of the protest.
Bandhugon, Bangladesh ke swadhinta sangram ko Bharat ke kone kone se, har party se, samaj ke har varg se, समर्थन प्राप्त था। तत्कालीन प्रधानमंत्री श्रीमती इंदिरा गांधी जी के प्रयास और उनकी महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका सर्वविदित है। उसी दौर में 6 दिसंबर 1971 को अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी जी ने कहा था, हम न केवल मुक्ति संग्राम में अपने जीवन की आहुति देने वालों के साथ लड़ रहे हैं, लेकिन हम इतिहास को एक नई दिशा देने का भी प्रयत्न कर रहे हैं।
शेख हसीना टू शेयर्ड अ रादर पर्सनल स्टोरी। शी रिकाउंटेड हाउ हर फादर एंड फैमिली वर असैसिनेटेड एंड हाउ इंडिया हेल्प्ड हर।
आई रिमेंबर विद ग्रेट एंग्विश एंड सैडनेस द 15th ऑफ अगस्त 1975 which is a dark day, night for Bangladesh when Bangabandhu, the father of the nation, was assassinated, and my mother, Sheikh Fazilutunnisa Mujib, my three brothers, freedom fighter Captain Sheikh Kamal, freedom fighter Lieutenant Sheikh Jamal, my two sisters-in-law Sultana Kamal and Rosie Jamal,
Lieutenant Sheikh Jamal,
and my 10-year-old brother, Russell, my only uncle, freedom fighter Sheikh Abu Nasir, who were brutally assassinated by the killers on 15th August 1975. The people who grabbed power had tried to wipe out the name of Bangabandhu and the correct history from the minds of the people. Ladies and gentlemen, India was also beside Bangladesh. All the political parties of Bangladesh, of India, all political parties of India are always united in one issue, and that is being beside Bangladesh and the people of Bangladesh.
Both Sheikh Hasina and Prime Minister Modi also mentioned the contribution of former Indian Prime Minister Indira Gandhi in the liberation of Bangladesh. And it is stories like these that bind the two countries and their leaders. History serves as a solid base. The present and the future are built on it. With policies that favor both sides, from trade relations to the supply of vaccines, India and Bangladesh are coming closer as partners. Bangladesh has received 2 million doses of Wuhan virus vaccines as gift. And today, Prime Minister Modi gifted another 1.2 million doses to them. Sheikh Hasina said India is her country's best development partner. Today was just the first half of engagements. Tomorrow, Prime Minister Modi is expected to engage in a wide-ranging conversation with his Bangladeshi counterpart, Sheikh Hasina. A trade pact could be on the cards. Both sides could boost cooperation in health, railway connectivity, border development, and startups. WeOn is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news on the move.